Hello and welcome to the final day of judo action from the 30th Universiade. We've seen 32 medals handed out already. The final eight will be won today in the team events. And the Japanese, as a team, are sitting top of the overall gold medal table at the Universiade with 13 golds, but just think, six of those golds are from judo. Are they about to add to that? We start with Takeda against Bobrikova.
First penalty goes to Takeda for passivity. Oh, Uchigari right away for Wazari, for Takeda.
And she's been given a Wazari for that. So Japan on the up at the moment. Can she get a hold on? Right. The hold is on. The clock is counting.
Kamisho Gatami is one of the tougher holds to get out, and that's exactly what she has on Bobrikova. And the second Wazari goes to Takeda for... Oh, sorry. That was...
It has now. The second Wazari gives the match to Ryoko Takeda. And Bobrikova lost her fight in the semi-finals, and she's now lost it in the final as well. So Japan, one up. So a change of personnel. Golomidova of Russia comes on. Tomizawa of Japan will take her on in the under 57 kilo category.
Both fighters came in strong. No uchigari attempt from Golomidova. She's working on a triangle reversal from there. The first penalty for gripping to Golomidova, for gripping on the same side. Now she has a belt grip. Working on a Tsutemi Waza, sacrifice technique. Didn't manage to turn Tomizawa onto her back or side.
And in one of the bronze medal matches, Brazil are one up against Germany. It's the latest from mat three.
Golomidova tried again, another attempt with a sacrifice throw. And picks up a second penalty for passivity.
And the Koreans are one up against the French in the in their bronze medal match. But the Russian here in a little bit of trouble.
Oh, there's a big attempt to throw from Tomizawa with that Taiyotoshi. She's very dangerous. She just comes across, misses a little bit on the rotation of her opponent's upper body. But it was a very strong attack, nevertheless. A minute left.
Yeah, I was going to say, so a minute left. Time is running out. But the Russian has to be careful. Another penalty, and she'll be disqualified. She'll lose the match. Three penalties, and you're out.
Nice combination there. A foot sweep.
Golomidova lost her semi-final fight as well.
Uchimada. Attempt from Golomidova. Was a good solution for her opponent's pushing movement.
30 seconds to go. Tomizawa burst onto the scene back in 2015. She's still only 19.
Hey.
But since then, she's managed a bronze at the Junior World Championships, and this year took the silver at the Asian Pacific. A real force for the future, Kana Tomizawa. Can she win her fight here? Can she add to Japan's score in this team final?
Well, you see, Gomidova is smart because as she approaches the edge of the mat, she does an uchimata, which is a legitimate attack, instead of stepping out and picks up a third penalty. And now they decide this match in the golden score period.
Next score wins, whoever that will be.
And again, that uchimata on the edge of the mat from Gomidova.
She can't allow herself to be just pushed out, to step out of the mat. She'll pick up a penalty for that. So, as you say, she's putting in these clever attempted throws.
Exactly. You can see
she's got a high grip, the Japanese and the Russian.
Well, change of direction. Came in with the uchimata, tries a sacrifice technique, dropping her back.
And a penalty to the Japanese for passivity.
You can see Tomizawa's really pushing forward. Came in for a taiotoshi again. A very close match between these two. You can see Tomizawa likes to keep her opponent near the edge. And it really forces.
Why would that be?
Because she's trying, well, I would say she looks like she's trying to get another penalty to win the match. But also she wants to get a big reaction from her opponent because she knows her opponent doesn't want to step out. And hence, Gomidova has to push back.
And oh, she just picked up the third penalty. So the Russian has lost this on penalties. And Tomizawa picks up the win to make it 2-0 to Japan. So Japan now only needs one more win to take the gold medal. So the next pair step up, Kamila Badurova of Russia wearing the blue, and on the left-hand side we'll have Nana Kota of Japan, the 21-year-old in her second Universiade, attempting to win her second gold of this Universiade.
And this is the women's under 63 kilograms weight category. And both are right-handed fighters. And pushing forward, leaning forward.
Get a measure of each other in these early stages of the fight. The first 30 seconds gone now.
They both are playing cautiously, keeping the pressure on the wrist of their opponent.
Oh, and a penalty goes to the Japanese and the Russian. It's a penalty apiece. Referee wants to see more attacking, more action.
That was an uchimata from Kota. Now you're seeing more attacks from the players. Instead of settling on a grip and stay in a static position, you can see Kota is moving, attacking at every opportunity. Deep grip from Badurova. Came in for a makikomi attempt.
Now she's trying to get a hold on. Her legs are caught up. And the thing that stands out, really, apart from the Japanese success, they've all got gold next to their names for this Universiade, is just how young they are. They're all 2 or 3 years younger than their Russian opponents.
That's true.
This competition is all about the future of these sports at the Universiade. And I think we're definitely seeing strength in depth for the future of women's judo in Japan.
I think it's safe to say, oh, big Harai Makikomi. So close. Budarova got the lift for a moment there, just didn't really manage to have a complete rotation. You can see she came all the way in, tried hard to rotate. Bakota just stopped that action. Bakota's pushing forward. Also, Togari came off a Sonaki grip. Well, she's working on a turnover now, going the other direction.
So Badarova managed to avoid the Iso Togari.
Well, both are evenly matched so far in this contest.
And these teams been through four matches to get to this final. So this is a fifth fight of the day for both the Russian and the Japanese judokas at the end of what will feel like a long tournament for them.
Oh, into the reverse kisagatami. Kota managed to roll her opponent.
So Kota already has a wazari on the board.
That is another wazari for Awasete Ippon.
That's three victories for Japan. That's the gold medal for the Japanese women. Yet again, Japan reigns in the women's categories. For Maya Akiba, who won't even have to fight here, it's her third medal of these games. For the others, it's all their second gold of the games. Nana Kota seals the deal for Japan against Russia, 3-0. Well, I promised you a minimum of six fights, a maximum of, I've lost count now, 10, wasn't it?
10, yeah.
And so far, the first one is over in three. So we're heading to a minimum of six. Well, yep. Congratulations to the Japanese. A 3-0 victory in this gold medal contest sees the women's team gold go to Japan. Let's turn our attention now to the men's team final. It's Korea against Russia. Korea 2, Russia 2. One final match to decide it, and it's the heavyweights, the over 90 kilos. Ruslan Shakhbazov of Russia up against Min Jong Kim of Korea.
Two real heavyweights fighting here.
Well, the Russian won gold in this weight category earlier on in the week. Can he now win gold for his team?
Well, both are left-handed fighters. Both have classic lapel and sleeve grip, trying to keep each other at a distance. The Russians leaning a little bit.
We were both impressed, weren't we, by this weight category and by how agile and nimble and fast the heavyweights have been in this Universiade.
That's right. They surely don't disappoint.
Just update you on the other bronze medals. Japan 1-0 up against Germany at the moment, and it's 1-1 between Brazil and Azerbaijan. 2-2 between Korea and Russia for the gold and silver. All square, a penalty apiece.
You can see Kim is trying to generate movement with his left hand on the lapel. And it's a really good way, and he's trying for that Seonagi, Morote Seonagi. Oh, and here he is. So agile for a big man, just dropping under beneath his opponent like that. We have seen in the earlier days, Kim can really pull off the drop Seonagi, which is not very common for players of this weight category. And that's what makes him dangerous. And Shakhbazov is a very powerful player.
And the Japanese picks up a second penalty. Sorry, the Korean picks up a second penalty.
Pressure is on Kim now, do all the attacks. Shakhbazov can be a big thrower, takes his time, sets up his throws, waits for his opponent to make a mistake.
Real atmosphere in the hall now, as this gold medal goes down to the wire. The Korean attempts a throw. Oh. Can the Russian get him in a hold?
Kim's desperately trying to get out of that, and he manages to flip onto his belly. Oh, he did a really good Seonagi attempt, dropping between his opponent's legs, but Shakhbazov has such a good defense and posture that he was able to stop that and almost pin Kim.
Kim, just 18 years old, already a cadet world champion, former junior Asian champion, so he's used to performing in front of a loud crowd.
A Tomonagi, wow, what a lift. That was a well-timed.
And you need it. Real strength in your legs to do that.
And good timing too for players of this weight. That was completely unexpected from Kim.
So a penalty for passivity to the Russian. So we really are square with the clock counting down to the final 30 seconds of the final fight to decide the team gold medal in the men's section. Two penalties apiece, 2-2 the score.
I can see the Russians pushing forward, and Kim tries very hard to generate movement, which is nice to see, instead of just blocking his strong opponent. He's working with his arms and his shoulders to generate some reactions.
And we have the gong, we're into golden score. No late controversial throw at the end of time this time. Four fights to get to this final, and it's come right down to golden score of the final fight of the final match.
You can see Shakhbazov is really trying hard to dominate his Korean opponent, and Kim is not letting that happen. I think we're going to see one of these players trying a big technique at this point.
They'll be aware they've got to pull something out of the hat now.
Morote Seonagi from Kim, and straight away to a strangle from Shakhbazov. Well defended by Kim.
And tiredness will start to creep in as well.
Definitely.
This category were the first category to fight on Thursday. But they will have also been involved in the men's open category yesterday. So they've seen plenty of action to get to this point.
Well, I think the referee is going to give out penalty.
Oh, is this going to be decided on a penalty? It'd be a shame if it was, but I think you're right. The referee's looking over at the jury. You're watching it on video. They're watching it back. And it's a third penalty, an elimination for the Korean Minjong Kim. Russia have been given this fight.
Well, Kim got a penalty for holding up the same side without generating any kind of attack. And I think he was trying to explain to the referee.
So Kim complains, but Shakhbazov wins. And Russia win the men's team final 3-2. With the deciding fight being decided on penalties. Ruslan Shakhbazov wins the gold for Russia, his second gold of this Universiade. And so Russia can now celebrate their third gold medal in the judo this Universiade. Okay, so smiles all round in the crowd, and the judo is over for the 30th Universiade from Lincoln Han. Thanks very much for joining us. It's been a fascinating insight into the judo. And from me, Alec Wilkinson, it's goodbye for now.
Thank you, Andrew.